Good morning students, today we are going to see new topic data handling. Okay, so in this first we will see what is data. In our day to day life, we might have come across information such as supposed to be the marks obtained by the students from your class in the maths test. Okay, that is the data is there with us. Again, another example, the runs made by or runs scored by the batsman in the last 10 matches, cricket match. Okay, and again afterwards, one more examples, that is the number of story books read by each students from your class. So all these informations collected in a such a manner or such a cases is called data. Okay, now sometimes the data is represented by the graphically. So by this way we will get the clear idea about the data or clear idea about the what it is represent. Okay, so here in the last year or in the earlier classes we have learned the different types of, see here, pictograph we have already learned. Then pictograph means what? Pictorial representation of the data is called the pictograph. Okay, then bar graph, sometimes the given information is shown by with the graph, that is bar graph. And why we are using the double bar graph? Double bar graph means suppose the marks obtained by the students in the last two test of the maths subject, okay, or any other subject, suppose in the pre-midterm and in the post-midterm, and if we compare these marks of the mathematics, so pre-midterm and post-midterm marks, okay, then all other subjects we can take together also, maths, science, social science, then English, Marathi, Hindi, all are the subject. And two tests, if we will compare them, this supposed to be, we will show these marks for the pre-midterm and this marks we will show for the post-midterm. Pre and post-midterm. So, for the pre-midterm, how many marks that students, particular students got in the Marathi, and for the post-midterm, how many marks got in Marathi. Like this, Hindi, English and all subject, right? That we will see with the help of one. So first we will see what is the pictograph. So pictograph means what? The pictorial information, pictorial representation of the given information is called a pictograph. Okay, suppose the company produces the car in each month. Okay, so how to represent this company produces many of the cars in each month? Suppose in the month of the July, right, in the month of July company produces the 500 cars. Is it possible to show with this picture? We can we draw here 500 cars? No. So we have to use one idea, right? So supposed to be one car means 100 cars. Okay, so if we have to trace show the 500 cars, then how we can show? We will, in the front of month of June, we will draw 5 cards. Okay, so 5 cards means what? Actually 500 cards. So here first we write 1 card is equals to 100 card. Like in the pictograph example is there, suppose the company produces the water bottles. Okay, so information about the each month, how many each month the company produces the many more bottles, water bottle. So if you take in the month of June, okay, so June, July, August, right? So in the month of June company produces supposed to be 700 bottles, right? So this we are, what is here, we have to show the information by pictures, right? So pictograph we have to do. So is it possible to draw here the 700 bottles? Not possible. So we have to take that one bottle Okay, one bottle means how many? 100 bottles. Right, so like this one bottle, we will draw the picture of bottle. So that is 100 bottle, right? So if in the month of, see here, if I will draw here, so how many bottles in the month of June the company produces? Of course, 1, 2, 3, 4 means 1 bottle means 100 bottles. So how many are here? 400 bottles. Okay. In the month of July, so here this bottle will be half. Okay, so what we can raise from this half? This half means what? Half of the 100, so 50. So here how many bottle produces in the month of July? 1, 2, 3 and half means what? 350. So here from these pictures we can get the proper idea about the information. So how many bottles are produced in the month of June? There are the 400 bottles here. 350 bottles, and here suppose we will draw okay, so how many bottles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total is 600 bottles are produced in the month of August. Okay, so pictorial information, pictograph means what? From the picture we can get the proper idea, we can get the proper information about the given data. Now we will see what is the bar graph. Okay, now we will see what is the graph, bar graph, right? So bar graphs are two types we can draw. First, single bar graph and double bar graph, right? So double graph, bar graph means on the same graph paper we can show the double information about the data. Okay, now here in this graph we have to draw the single bar graph. Okay, so one are being given here, July, August, September, October, November and December, and here the production of watches, or sorry, here the number of watches sold in each month it is given. In the month of July, how many watches are sold? This 1000. August 1500, September 2000, October 1500, November 2500 and December 1500, right? Now this information we will show on the graph, right? So everyone knows that your partition plane is your graph paper, you have to use for this purpose, right? So on the graph paper we have to draw this vertical axis, that is your y-axis, okay, and this is your horizontal axis, so this x-axis, right? Now on the graph paper there 1 centimeter boxes are there, this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and so on. Okay, so like this, right? Now here this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Okay, now here this month of July, August, we can take downside from this box and from this box. So number of watches sold on where will be there? On the y-axis. So on the y-axis what will be there? This number of watches sold. Okay, so started from 1000. So here we will take What is the notice, sir? Here supposed to be 1500. So we have to start. Is it possible from the 100, 200, 300, 400? Not possible on the graph paper, right? So we will take from this 500. Reading from 500, then 1000, then 1500, 2000, then 2500 and up, right? And here July, August, September, October, November and December. So this gap will take for June, July. Then we will remove this one gap. This is for August we will take. This we will remove. Then September we will remove. This October, then November, and this is for December. Okay, now in the month of July, how many number of watches sold? 1000. So from here, what is 1000 seen is here, right? So we will draw the vertical line exactly in front of the 1000 number, and we will join from here this. And okay, so this is from here we can get the idea about how many watches are sold in the month of July. How many? 1000, right? We can draw the graph from this information, or if the information will be given in this, like if information is given in this way by drawing the graph, then we can say that how many watches are produced or how many watches are sold in which month. That proper information we can get from this graph. Okay, now here in the month of August 1500, so where our scale is 1500 here, right? So in the month of August we can go for the how many are 1500. Okay, so this is 1500. This from this we can say that how many watches are sold in the month of August? 1500. In the September 2000. So 2000 is here. Okay, so we have to draw this graph for this September. Then October 1500. So 1500 is here. Then November 2500 is here. So we have to use the scale to take the proper reading from the y-axis. And for December 1500, again we will come to this side. Okay, here this is the representation, and this is the representation of the single bar graph. We can say this single bar graph of this given information. Here this is called the graph, single bar graph. Okay, or sometimes the information is given in this manner, and they will ask the question how many watches are sold in the month of October. So from this information, from this graphical representation, we can say the, we can get the idea about particular month how many watches are sold, right? So in the October, month of October, how many watches are sold here? 1500. In the month of November, how many are there? 2500. Okay, now we will see what is the double bar graph. Okay, here graph is given, graphical representation is already given here. In box, if here we will see that empty box is the hobby, and here lines are given in the box, that is for the cycling. Then what it is exactly? So here school A, school B, school C, this is on X axis, okay, and on Y axis what is given? The number of students, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. It means that the how many students are going to school A, school B and school AAC by walking and by cycling. So from this representation of the graph, we can come to understand this is the information about the number of students, how they are going by walking or by cycling into the different schools, that school A, school B and school C. Okay, now here in the school A, if the question will be there, in the school A, how many students are going to school by walking and how many students are going to school by cycling. So from this representation we can know that, we can understand that the school A, in that this empty box is all for walking. So how many students are going by walking? They are 10, 20, 30 and 40. So how many students are going by walking? 40 students. And in the same school, the students are going by cycling. So how many students are there? Here this middle line is of 0.5, right? So here this 40, 41, 42, 43, 44 and 45. So how many students are going in a school by cycling? That is 45, right? Means that in a school there are the two types of the students. Some students are going by walking and some students are going by cycling. So at a time the two information is shown. Okay. So some students are going by walking and students are going by cycling. Similarly, here in the school B, if asked how many students are going by cycling, then we have to see just in front of this what is the number. Okay, so how many students are there? There are here 35 students are going by cycling. Okay, and how many students are going by walking? So we have to see these lines. Okay, so this 50 and this 55. So how many students are going by walking? 55 students are going by walking. And here we have school C. How many students are there by going by walking? We have to see this number in front of this. Okay, how many? 15 students are there going by walking. And here how many are there? The 35 students are going by cycling. Okay, so at the times we will get the two types of information, the students how they are going into the school by walking or by cycling. And this type of graphical representation is called as the double bubble. Okay, next part we will see on the tomorrow. Thank you.